Concord, Massachusetts, April 19th, 1775. We were fighting for our lives, fighting for our town of Concord, fighting to save our weapons from destruction. But we all knew we were also fighting for so much more. We were fighting for freedom. This morning, a man on a horse sped into town. His face was full of fear and panic. I asked him, "Sir, what is wrong? What has happened?" Out of breath, the man answered, "The British have attacked the town of Lexington. They destroyed their weapons and killed several militiamen. Get every Minuteman in the area and get them here to Concord. The British will be here soon." The man sped off on his horse as quickly as he had come. I ran to the horse stable and found my friend Jacob. I told Jacob what the rider had told me, and Jacob gathered several men to ride out into the surrounding area and round up as many colonial soldiers as he could. I ran around town warning people and gathering soldiers to fight against the British. I tried to move as fast as I could, but I heard the British marching into town. Me and the other soldiers that I had gathered were standing on the north end of town by the bridge. I heard the sound of exploding gunfire. Great, I thought to myself. They destroyed all of our extra weapons and ammo. Then I heard the British soldiers marching toward us. "Hide," I whispered to everyone. We all scrambled to the bushes along the side of the road. I saw the British soldiers coming from a long way away, their red coats shining brightly in the morning sun. There were a lot of them, and not many of us. I only had about 100 men with me, and it looked like there might be 500 or more British soldiers coming toward us. "Stay here," I told the men with me. "Wait until the British soldiers are on the bridge. Then start firing from where you're at. Stay hidden." When the soldiers were all on the bridge, we sent hundreds of bullets towards them. The plan worked great. Several British soldiers hit the ground, and those that were still alive looked around, wondering what the heck had hit them. We continued to fire at them. Finally, the British figured out where we were hiding and started firing back. Some of the colonists were getting hit, and I got scared. I thought, "This is it. We're all going to die." Suddenly, from the north, Jacob came with 1,000 soldiers. The new colonial soldiers fired at the British, wounding many of them. The British soldiers cried in agony and ran away. Me and my men cheered, and I thanked Jacob for coming back with so many people. The British wanted to run away from us and go back to Boston, but we wouldn't let them. We followed them and hid in the bushes and shot at them from the bushes. Whenever the British would stop and start shooting at the bushes, we would run further up the road and hide again. When the British got to where we were, we shot at them from the bushes again. You could see that the British soldiers were terrified. They had no idea where the gunshots were coming from, and no idea how to stop us. Our goal was to shoot every single one of them before they got back to Boston. But before we had a chance, 1,000 more British soldiers arrived and forced us to turn back. We killed many British soldiers, but not many colonists died. I did hear about a 14-year-old boy that died in the battle named Edward Barber. Edward heard the British coming and ran to his window to watch the fighting. At that point, the British were scared and thought that everyone moving in a house or in the bushes might be a colonial soldier trying to kill them. A British soldier aimed his musket at Edward and killed him with one shot. He was the last person to die in the Battle of Lexington and Concord. Still, there were not many stories like this. Most of the colonists lived through the battle, and we proved that the British have something to be scared of. Hopefully now the British will realize that they have made a big mistake and will allow us colonists to have more rights without any more bloodshed. Next time, it's an uphill battle for the best army in the world, right here on History Fits.